Hi, in this video I'm going to show you how to separate a foreground object from a background using Roto Brush and how to create mats using refined mats. So we have our video on a timeline. It's a short 4-second video of a man walking beside the wall and I want to put him on a separate layer. I could probably do it with the mask, but it would took me a horrible amount of time. Okay, so we are gonna to use a Roto Brush tool for this. First, we need to duplicate our layer by pressing Ctrl-D, Command-D on the Mac, and we need to double-click our layer. So it opens in a new window, the layer window. Just always remember to have resolution set to full. Roto Brush works the best when the resolution is set to the fullest. Okay, so we are going back to our window. We need to select our Roto Brush tool from here and we can zoom a little in. Okay, so we can change the size of our brush by pressing Ctrl Command on the Mac and moving our mouse. So we'll set it like that. And zoom out a little, and with the green stroke, which is the foreground stroke, we need to paint inside our subject, not around our subject, inside our subject. Okay, there are a few things to fix. Let's start from this. And by pressing Alt, Option on the Mac, the brush changes its color to red, which is now the background brush. And we paint outside our subject, so the program knows this isn't our subject. Like here. Now, when we click and a little keep it on the Roto Brush, we have an option to choose Refine Edge tool. It's best for textures like hair or the fur. So with our Refine Edge tool, we know we have it because now it's blue. We need to paint around our hair. Over the line would be the best. Created an alpha matte mask. The black region is transparent region and the white region is our hair. So you can see it works very good for the hair. And now where we are happy with our base frame, we can jump frame by frame by pressing Ctrl Command on the Mac and pressing arrows left or right, in this case right. Works very good. And if we know our subject doesn't make any sudden moves and the propagation would probably be very good, we can move our CTI, current time indicator, right to the end. And now you can see the propagation has started. The video has 89 frames, so we need to get every frame by frame. Okay, by pressing this, we can toggle alpha overlay, red alpha overlay. Of course, we can change the color to a different one overlay, but it's okay. And here is the percentage of transparency. And now we can check how it works if there aren't any unwanted region like that one in our selection. So let's find the first frame and shows. Here and we need to just start fixing it, these few frames, frame by frame. Okay, after fixing, we can push our indicator again to the end. Let's click this alpha mask. Oh, there's a jump here. And when we are happy with our selection, we just click freeze. Okay, we can close our layer window now. And when we disable our below layer, we have our subject on a separate layer. I just want to add one thing about choosing the base frame. Always choose the base frame when your subject is fully in the scene. Okay, right now we can be happy with that selection, but we can easily adjust it with a lot of options here. We have options for our Roto Brush and for Refine Edge Matte. Both effects have separate parameters, so we can make a feather so these lines don't look like this sharp. Yes, we can shift edge inside just to get rid of this weird halo effect. With reduced chatter, we reduce erratic changes to edges from one frame to the next, so it's the best always to put it on 100%. I think it's okay. Just let's a little fix our hair. Let's add smoothness to it. It reduces the sharpness. Let's add a little feather and shift edge a little bit. I think that's okay. For example, when your object is moving very fast, you can use a motion blur on the propagation lines. But in this case, I won't use it because my object is walking very slowly. And by pressing Decontaminate Edge Colors, it will clean the color of edge pixels. Background color is removed. Yeah, it's very helpful with halos and contaminations caused by motion blur. But in this case, our object is very slow, so there are no any contaminations created by motion blur, and this halo which you saw I deleted by increasing in the minus shift edge. So we can now easily, for example, put something like that, change the position of our man walking. And voila, that's it. Our subject is on a separate layer. We can do whatever we want with that layer. We can even duplicate it all like that. So there's gonna be two men walking, and we can duplicate it even more. So there are several men walking. And of course, we can also put a text or something between our subject and our background. Just creating new text. Let's just call it, for example, business. Get a little bigger. And let's put it between those two layers. Okay, I think that's it. I hope you enjoyed and learned something. If you have any questions, just post them in the comment section. Don't forget to subscribe our channel for new videos. Bye.